Radios with a USB port can control a USB storage device or an iPod using the radio buttons. The USB connector is located in the center console. To connect an iPod, connect one end of the USB cable that came with the iPod to the iPod dock connector and connect the other end to the USB port located in the center of the console. If you have an older iPod model that is not supported, it can still be connected to the auxiliary input jack using a standard 3.5 millimeter stereo cable. When using the auxiliary input jack, you cannot use the radio controls to control the iPod. Use the Tune button to turn to select files. Press the Seek button to go to the next track. Press and hold the Reverse button to reverse playback quickly. Press and hold the Forward button to advance playback quickly. Tracks can be searched for by using the menu system. To use the menu system, push the Menu Select knob to display the MP3 menu. Turn the Menu Select knob to highlight an option from the MP3 menu. The available options are Shuffle, Playlist, Artists, Albums, All Songs, Genres, Composers, and Eject iPod. The radio can play MP3 or WMA files that were recorded onto a CDR or CDRW disc. The USB port can play MP3 and WMA files that are stored on a USB storage device, as well as the files that are stored on an iPod. USB supported devices include USB flash drives, portable USB hard drives, fifth generation or later iPods, iPod Nanos, iPod Touch, and iPod Classic. Not all iPods and USB drives are compatible with the USB port. Make sure that the iPod has the latest firmware from Apple for proper operation. iPod firmware can be updated using the latest iTunes application. See apple.com/iTunes for help with identifying your iPod. Go to apple.com/support.